हेलो एवरीवन, आई एम रिंकू धीमन, वर्किंग एज एन असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर इन इलेक्ट्रिकल इंजीनियरिंग डिपार्टमेंट एट आरपी आईआईटी टेक्निकल एंड मेडिकल कैंपस करनाल। सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द हाइब्रिड पावर जनरेशन बाय सोलर एंड विंड कॉम्बिनेशंस। सो द टर्म हियर, द मीनिंग ऑफ हाइब्रिड, एक्चुअली हाइब्रिड इज नथिंग बट दैट इज द रिजल्ट ऑफ the combination of two or more component, we can say. So that is called hybrid. So we'll talk about over here, like the power generation from solar as well as wind simultaneously. We will combine that, we'll make a hybrid system from that. So first of all, we must be understand renewable energy. What is renewable energy sources? That can be renew itself in the nature, we can say. So renewable is basically, renewable means we can renew the things, okay, or it will be regenerated itself in the nature. And the second thing, it is available in the widespread, we can say that it is widely available actually. So it is not abundant like coal, other fossil fuels are available in a limited range. Thirdly, we can say it is the free from the pollutions. So as we know that from energy generation from the solar or wind, there is a no pollution related issue like that has occur in our solar, coal power plants, fossil fuel power plants, etc. And it finally it will produce a clean and pure energy in comparison to our coal based plant. So solar energy is basically based on the principle that sun rays converted into electrical energy. So that basically converted through this solar panel. So we can say that the sun rays from the sun are like mounted on this solar panel, and the solar panel will convert this sun rays into the DC current. So this is our DC current actually. So that DC current will go through the charge controller basically, that will generate the power into the regulated format, and that regulated supply is fed to our battery, so it will store the DC energy over there. And finally we will put this energy into inverter, which convert our DC into AC, and we will get the AC power over here. And we can also use directly DC power to operate our DC equipments. Secondly, we must understand this is the unlimited supply. So we can say that sun rays are available in unlimited range. No negative impact over there. Like we can say simply no negative impact in our coal plant based system. We always with some kind of residue over there, that is in terms of ash, in terms of pollution, etc. And same way we can also understand like in the radio power plants, or we can say that in nuclear power plants, we have a great problem with disposals, radioactive disposal, we can say that. So no negative impact of the solar energy. Free of cost, as we know that sun rays are available freely in an environment, so no need to like spend on the raw material like we are doing in the coal power plant system. That is free from pollutions, already discussed that thing. We don't need get any like wastage material, or we don't get any environment pollution from the solar energy system. Then the second is the wind energy. The wind energy basically simply convert our wind energy into electrical energy. So no fuel cost over there, as we know that wind is freely available in the environment, and it is also free from the pollution. So this is the basic structure of our wind energy system. Our wind is struck on the blade of the turbine. So this is our blade of the turbine, and that combined with our gearbox, right? And that gearbox is connected with our generators through the Nestle, and that generator is basically connected to our transformer with the power cables and through these towers. And this transformer is directly connected to our switch yard through the poles of the power transmission lines. So the main concern to set up this hybrid system or solar or wind power system, we we must be understand the geographical reason. So this is the very important factor where we have to put our solar and wind power plant. In the solar, for the solar, we understand the geographical region should be like the average solar radiation should be 5 kilowatt hour per square meter. And the second, the availability of sunshine, our available per year should be 2300 to 3200, and the available of most part of the country. So that is the main geographical reason for the solar energy generations. Same way, wind energy generation plant we have to set up, we must understand the south and western coastal areas are ideal location for that, because the wind speed or the wind throughout the year will be almost constant or in a large speed over there. So annual average speed of wind will be throughout the year will be 5 to 6 meter per second. And the second attractive option to supplement the energy supply. So wind energy generation is a very attractive supplement for the energy supply. So here the term hybrid means the things made by combining two or more different elements. So this is known as the hybrid system. Now the second is need of hybridization क्या होता है, right? Why we have to need this hybrid product? So for increasing the output, we must be implement this hybrid system. As we know that individual power station can't be feed the utilities demand. So we have to use this hybrid term for the increasing output. The second is for fulfilling the demand of consumer. Right, already told this thing. Individual power plant can't be fulfill the demand of the consumer. So we have to implement this hybrid system providing uninterrupted power supply. So hybrid means the combination of two or more elements, we can say that. So if one station power substation or station will be failed, then we can depend on the other one. Okay, so that is the power uninterrupted power supply system related things. The last is system can design for both off-grid and on-grid. So we can design this hybrid system for on-grid and off-grid system. So off-grid system or on-grid system is related to our solar power plant, and the combination of that will be we can also make with our thermal power plant, right? And the same way, if the solar energy is available, we will utilize that thing. If the solar energy not available, we can use the power from the grid then. So different hybrid power technology over there. So we can use the different combination of different hybrid system. That is solar or wind hybrid system, we can say that. Solar and diesel hybrid system, wind and hydro hybrid system, and finally wind and diesel hybrid power system. So these are, we can make the combination of different components to generate a hybrid power technology. So we'll discuss over here the solar wind hybrid power system. So ideally, the alternative in areas where the wind velocity is 5 to 6 kilometer basically available throughout the year. So we can establish this solar wind power system over there. So power clear and non-polluting. So because there is a no wastage, or we can say that no hazard gases produced in the like emission of the coal, etc. So this is the pollution-free power generation. The complement to each other. So solar and wind are basically freely available in the nature. So they are generating basically in a complement manners. Then stable powers. We can generate the stable power because throughout the year, if we are available with this kind of velocity and sun rays are available throughout the year, then we can generate a stable power from this hybrid system. So this is a component of our hybrid generator system. We need a solar panel. The solar panel is directly convert the sun rays into the electricity. That is our DC current basically. We can directly fed to our load as well. So we can see that sun rays are feeding on this solar power plant and this solar panels. And this solar panel is nothing but the combination of our N-type and P-type material. And between that, there is a junction. So we can also directly fed this positive terminal is connected with the positive terminal of load and negative terminal is connected with the negative terminal of the load. So we are just illuminate our lamp by directly by using the solar energy. We need also a controller that monitor the system starting and stopping in engine as needed. So here the controller means is directly that is work on the MPPT techniques, maximum power point technique, we can say that. So it will always track the maximum point that harness the maximum energy from the sun rays. Okay, so we can say that solar controller based on the MPPT technique is directly connected between our solar panel and the load. So it will balance the or we can say that it regulate the undesirable or we can say that unbalanced solar energy generation into the regulated supply as per our load demand. So that is the function of your MPPT solar controller. So battery we need, we can use any kind of battery, lead acid battery, nickel acid battery kind of thing. Inverter basically convert the DC power into AC, that our domestic load is AC basically, so we need inverter for that purpose. The working will be the simple like that, solar and wind turbine produced AC power we can say, sorry DC power. So we can say that here is the wind turbine and here is the solar panels. So directly we can say that so through this wind turbine, the wind will be stuck on this blade of this turbine that will rotate the rotor of this turbine, and rotor is directly connected with your generator, and generator will generate our DC supply, we can say that. And similarly, solar panel is connected with our direct charger controller over here. See, this charger controller is directly our MPPT controller, we can say. Okay, so the variable supply from these two plants is converted into regulated supply, and that regulated DC supply is directly fed to our battery bank. We store this energy, or we can use directly fed to our inverter from this battery source that will convert this DC into AC and will fed to the user. So this is the working of our hybrid system. So these are the application of our solar hybrid system. We can utilize this in hotels, business, like in institutions and government buildings. We can say the large state houses, factories and manufacturing facilities, commercial power generation and street lighting. So many more application of these hybrid systems. Okay, so this is all about the hybrid power systems. Thank you very much. Please like and subscribe our channels. Stay tuned with us for more videos on the hybrid system. So in next lecture we will discuss about the hybrid system, like we can say that solar and hydro, wind and diesels. Stay tuned with us. Thank you very much.